due to the Hello Top Notchers! Welcome back to my YouTube channel. So again, so thank you to all my subscribers. And sa mga hindi pa po nakakapag-subscribe, just click the button below to subscribe and click the bell button for more video updates. And guys, if you want more videos like this, don't forget to like and share and please don't skip the ads. So let's begin with our discussion about your APGAR scoring system. So what is APGAR scoring system? So let's define your APGAR score. So if we say APGAR score is the standardized evaluation of the newborn's condition at birth. So this scoring system was devised by Dr. Virginia APGAR at siya po ay isang anesthesiologist. So take note nurses that APGAR scoring system was done and performed in the first minute of life and at the 5 minutes of life of the newborn. Okay? So ginagawa po natin yan 1 to 5 minutes after the birth of the baby. And if there's a need for your reassessment is usually done after 10 minutes. Again, so pag tinanong po sa board exam kung kailan ginagawa ni nurse ang ating APGAR scoring was usually performed 1 to 5 minutes after the birth of the baby. For the first minute of life or the first 1 minute of life, the nurse uses APGAR scoring to determine the general condition of the newborn, okay? So that is to determine the general condition of the newborn right after its delivery. And at 5 minutes APGAR score, it is used to determine the general adaptation of the newborn to the extrauterine life. So, titingnan natin kung paano po siya nakakapag-adapt extrauterine life. So, kung titingnan natin, mas importante po yung ating score sa 5 minutes kesa sa ating first minute. So, kahit na mataas po ang kanyang first minute score, kung bumaba ang score niya sa 5 minutes, there's a need for your nursing intervention there. So, nursing intervention is based on the score of your 5 minutes APGAR scoring. Again, so pag sinabi po natin first minute APGAR score, it is used to determine the general condition of the newborn. And if we say 5 minutes APGAR score, that is used to determine the general adaptation of the newborn to the extrauterine life or the adjustment of the newborn to its new environment. So, what are the parameters in your APGAR scoring system? So, take note in your APGAR scoring system devised by Virginia APGAR, we have your acronym APGAR. So, itong APGAR na ito, ito po yung mismong ating parameters. So, A for your appearance of the newborn, then P for the pulse of the newborn, G for the grimace, A for the activity, and R for the respiration. Again, so ulitin ko. So, we have your acronym APGAR for your APGAR scoring system. We have your A for the appearance, P for the pulse, G for the grimace, A for your activity, and R for your respiration. So, take note, these are the 5 parameters used in APGAR scoring system. And each parameter has its indicator, okay? So, example, yung ating appearance, ang kanyang indicator dito is your color of the baby. So, take note that the color of the baby is the least important, okay? The least important indicator in APGAR scoring. So, ito po yung pinaka-least na importante sa ating APGAR scoring system, the color of the baby. The next will be your letter P, your pulse, okay? So, the indicator for your pulse is the heart rate of the newborn. So, take note that heart rate or the pulse of the newborn is the most sensitive and the most significant, okay? It is the most sensitive indicator in your APGAR scoring system. So, napaka-importante po yung ating heart rate pagdating sa ating APGAR scoring system. And next, we have also letter G, the grimace of the newborn. So, if we say grimace, the indicator here is the reflex irritability of the newborn. Okay, while your activity, the indicator here is the muscle tone of the newborn. And for your respiration, the indicator here is the respiratory effort of the newborn. Then next, you have here our APGAR scoring system table. So we have here our parameters, the score of 0, 1, and 2. Okay, so we have your 0, 1, and 2 as your scoring system for your APGAR score. So in your parameters, sabi natin kanina, we have your appearance, the pulse, the grimace, the activity, and respiration. So we have your A, P, G, A, R of the APGAR acronym. So appearance is the color of the baby, pulse is the heart rate of the baby, and the grimace is the reflex irritability, and activity is the muscle tone, and for respiration, it is your breathing of the baby. Okay, so sa ating Apgar scoring system, nagbibigay po tayo dito ng score of 0, score of 1, and score of 2. So, it depends to the assessment of the nurse upon your scoring. Okay, so when the nurse performs the Apgar score and it assesses the color of the baby or the appearance of the baby, if the nurse assesses a blue baby or a cyanotic baby or a pale baby, the score here is 0. Okay, 0 pong score niya kapag siya ay pale, blue all over, or yung tatawag natin na cyanotic baby. But if the baby is born acrocyanotic, okay, so acrocyanosis means a pink body with blue extremity, okay? Kaya siya tinawag na acrocyanosis because the extremities is only the blue part, okay? And the body is pinkish. So, acrocyanosis is given a score of 1. Scored 1 po yan, okay? But if the baby is born pinkish all over the body or in a ruddy complex body, okay, the baby is given a score of 2. Okay, score niya po dun is 2 kapag siya pinkish all over the body. Again, ulitin ko, 0 for your cyanosis, 1 for your acrocyanosis, and 2 for your pink all over the body. The next assessment is the pulse of the newborn or the heart rate of the baby. So take note that heart rate is the most important and the most sensitive indicator in Apgar scoring. Sabi ko kanina, the least important is the color, and take note that the most important is the pulse rate or the heart rate of the newborn. Lumalabas din po yan sa exam. So if the heart rate of the newborn is absent, the score of the baby is 0. But if the heart rate is less than 100 beats per minute, the score is 1. And if the heart rate of the newborn is more than 100 beats per minute, it is scored as 2. Okay, ulitin ko. If the heart rate is absent, that is 0. If the heart rate is less than 100, that is 1. And if the heart rate is more than 100, that is scored as 2. Then after your pulse rate or the heart rate of the newborn assessment, we have your grimace assessment. And take note that the indicator for grimace is your reflex irritability. So for reflex irritability, we are using here your bulb syringe, okay? So if the newborn has no response or no response at all for the stimulation, that is scored as 0. But if the newborn has a grimace appearance, feeble cry when stimulated, that is given a score of 1. And if the newborn sneezes, cough, or pulls away when stimulated and have a good strong cry, the newborn score for your grimace is 2. Okay? Again, so I repeat, for no response for any stimulation, that is 0. For grimace, feeble cry, when stimulated, that is 1. And if the newborn sneezes, cough, or pulls away when stimulated and have a good strong cry, that is a score of 2. Then after your grimace reflex irritability assessment, next is the activity with the muscle tone of the baby. So take note, in your activity, the indicator here is the muscle tone of the baby. For a baby who was born limp, flaccid, or parang lantang gulay, okay? So that is given a score of 0. So no muscle tone is scored as 0. Okay? For some flexion of extremities or some muscle tone, that is scored as 1. And if the baby has a well-flexed extremities and have a good flexion, the score here is 2. Again, so if the baby was born limp, flaccid, okay, parang lantang gulay, paralyzed po siya, okay? So that is no tone, that is 0. If the baby is born some flexion of extremities and have a some muscle tone, that is given a score of 1. But if the baby has a well-flexed extremities and have a good flexion, that is given a score of 2, okay? And for the assessment of your respiration, we are assessing the respiratory effort of the baby or the breathing of the newborn, okay? So, if breathing is absent, that is scored at 0, okay? Again, so breathing is absent, that is scored at 0. And if the breathing is weak or irregular, or the baby's cry is weak or feeble, that is scored as 1. Always remember that a crying infant is a breathing infant. So if there's a weak or irregular cry or a feeble cry, it also suggests a weak respiration of the baby, okay? But if there's a lusty cry and a good strong cry, it suggests a good respiration of the baby, a good respiratory effort of the baby, okay? So take note, okay? Again, so cry is also used to determine the respiratory effort of the baby. A weak cry suggests a weak respiratory effort. A good strong cry and lusty cry suggests a good respiratory effort. So kapag meron siyang good and strong cry or lusty cry, that is also scored as 2 in your respiration or breathing effort of the baby. Then next, let's talk about your scoring system. So take note that the highest possible score in APGAR is 10. Okay? But usually, most of the newborns have only a score of 9 because of the presence of your acrocyanosis. So they only got 9 score because of the presence of your acrocyanosis due to the sluggishness of their peripheral circulation. So medyo mabagal pa po yung kanilang peripheral circulation. Kaya karamihan ng mga bata hindi po na perfect yung ating 10 score sa APGAR score. Okay? So kadalasan na nakuha lang ng mga babies natin is a score of 9 due to your acrocyanosis. And take note that the lowest possible score in APGAR is 0. Okay? The lowest possible score in APGAR is 0 and the highest possible score is 10, but most of the newborns have a score of 9. So if the total score of the baby in APGAR score is 0 to 3 points, it suggests a severely depressed or distressed newborn. Okay? So the baby here is in serious danger and it needs immediate resuscitation. So as a nurse or as a healthcare provider, we need to resuscitate the baby. So pwede po tayo dito mag-ambubag or endotracheal intubation. Okay? So the baby is in serious danger or it needs immediate resuscitation if the total score in APGAR score is 0 to 3 points. So take note that in APGAR scoring, the lower the score of the baby, the severely distressed the newborn. Tandaan niyo po yan. The lower the score, the severely depressed or severely distressed the newborn. Then next, if the total score of the newborn is 4 to 6 points, okay, it suggests a moderately distressed or moderately depressed baby. And the condition of the baby here is fair or guarded. A score of 4 to 6 points in APGAR score requires airway clearance such as your suctioning and supplementary oxygenation. But take note, administering high levels of oxygen to a premature neonate can cause blindness as a result of your retrolental fibroplasia or yung tinatawag natin na retinopathy of prematurity. So, be cautious sa ating pagbibigay ng oxygen sa mga premature babies. Again, so if the score of the baby is between 4 to 6 points, the baby is moderately distressed or moderately depressed and the condition is fair or guarded. So, take note, if the score of the baby is between 4 to 6 points, it requires airway clearance like your suctioning and supplementary oxygenation. But take note, when suctioning the newborn, suction the newborn properly. So, number one, position the infant with his neck slightly hyperextended in sniffing position. So, take note, the position of the baby during your suctioning is sniffing position. So, again, so in your essential newborn care, suctioning is unnecessary procedure unless if there's a sign of airway obstruction or nahihirapan ng huminga si baby or excessive mucus is present. So, number two, suction gently and quickly. So, for 5 to 10 seconds lang po yung ating suctioning. So, maximum of 10 seconds for your suctioning and take note to oxygenate the baby before and after your suctioning. And number three, suction the mouth first before the nose. So, unahin po natin yung mouth niya before the nose to prevent aspiration of your secretions. And number four, apply suction upon withdrawing the catheter and not upon entering or inserting your catheter. Okay? And number five, gentle rotating suctioning should be applied. No to vigorous suctioning because a vigorous suctioning can cause injury and trauma to your vagus nerve and it can cause bradycardia. Okay? So take note, place the newborn in a slight Trendelenburg position to facilitate further drainage of secretion kapag wala po tayong suction bulbs. Okay? So pag walang suctioning, walang suction material or suction equipment, you can position the baby slight Trendelenburg. Pag wala po tayong slight Trendelenburg, you can also position the baby semi-prone position. That is to drain your excess secretions. And if the score of the baby or the total score of your baby in your APGAR is 7 to 10 points, the baby is in a well and good condition. So, it is in good and in the best possible health. So, document and proceed to the newborn care procedure. So, take note, basta nasa 7 to 10 points ang ating APGAR score, proceed to your newborn care procedure after documenting your APGAR score. So, document and then proceed to the newborn care procedure. Again, 7 to 10 points suggests a well and good condition. Then, always remember to keep the newborn warm, okay? Kasi kapag ito yung nagkakaroon ng hypothermia, it causes your complications after delivery like your hypoglycemia, metabolic acidosis, and your hypothermia, okay? So, to keep the newborn warm, we have your mnemonics here, warm mnemonics. So, W for your wipe fluids and dry the newborn immediately after birth, but never remove your vernix caseosa. Okay, and letter A, adjust or set the room temperature between 25 to 28 degrees Celsius or close the doors and close the windows or drafts. Okay, and a radiant warmer 25 watts or wrap with warm dry blanket and ibigay kay nanay yung baby. And the most important here is the kangaroo mother care or the maintenance of the skin-to-skin contact. So, uninterrupted skin-to-skin contact is beneficial to prevent hypothermia of the newborn. So, we have here some examples of a common board question about your Apgar scoring of the newborn. So, question number one, the nurse is performing Apgar scoring of the newborn immediately after birth. The nurse notes that the heart rate is less than 100 and respiratory effort is irregular and the muscle tone shows some extremity flexion. The newborn grimaces when suctioned with a bulb syringe and the skin color indicates some cyanosis of the extremities. The nurse should most appropriately document which Apgar score of the newborn, A3, B5, C7, or D. Okay, so, iskuran natin dito yung baby. So, the nurse notes the heart rate is less than 100. So, the pulse here is 100, less than 100. So, a less than 100 pulse is scored as 1. Then next, the respiratory effort here is irregular. So, respiratory effort is irregular, that is scored as 1. And muscle tone shows some extremity flexion. So, the muscle tone is some flexion. So, that is scored also as 1. Then, the newborn grimaces when suctioned with bulb syringe. So, there's a grimace. So, grimace is 1. Kasi pag 2, that is sneezing, coughing, okay? And the skin color indicates some cyanosis of the extremities. So, ibig sabihin, hindi siya pinkish all over. So, the score here is 1 also. So, the total score in your Apgar here is 5. So, letter B is the correct answer for the example question number 1. And next, sample question number 2, we have your nurse Jovi's assessment reveals the following. The heart rate of the newborn is 110 beats per minute, has a vigorous cry, moves actively and with good flexion. So, normal skin color and bluish extremities. What should be the Apgar score of baby Sharon? A, 7 points, B, 10 points, C, 5 points, or D, 9 points. Okay, isa-isahin po natin. So, heart rate is 110 beats per minute. So, that is above 100 and that is scored as 2. Okay? So, has a vigorous cry. Vigorous cry is a good cry and that is scored as 2. Then, the baby moves actively. So, active moving is scored as 2 and a good flexion is also scored as 2. But the color of the baby is bluish extremity. So, skin color is good, but the extremities is bluish. So, that is the acrocyanosis. So, the color here or the appearance here is scored as 1. So, 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 1 is equal to 9 points. So, letter D is the correct answer here.